the Sarlacc, a creature from old Tatooine, regarded by locals as horror obscene. Apparently, what down its throat disappears is digested in pain for a good 1,000 years. Yes, it's a story that's sure to unnerve, but is this reputation one truly deserved? The merest of cursory examinations uncovers a hole in the above accusation. It posits, for one, a digestive enzyme still working long after the meal's lifetime. A 1,000-year stint in that stomachy cage would be mostly spent already dead of old age. Well, perhaps to the end of postponing fatality there's some arrangement that bestows immortality, but empowering your victim does seem to me a bit counterintuitive, don't you agree? If it takes a millennium to boil you away, that's 0.0003% in a day. And not that I'm now recommending you try it, but you lose mass faster on the Atkins diet. You do get dissolved, that seems pretty plain. But it happens too slowly to cause any pain. What was sold as a torture unspeakably cruel becomes a long dip in a big heated pool. We were told it was painful, that's true of course, but I would ask you now to consider the source. It was Jabba the Hutt, attempting to scare. He wouldn't know, he's not been down there. Inside the Sarlacc, it's really quite neat. No obligations, all the food you can eat. Spend your whole life just splashing about. Why do you think nobody's tried to get out? The Sarlacc's just trying to make some new chums. It gets very downhearted when nobody comes. It can't understand how it earns so much hate when it's zoned out its tummy as prime real estate. Its pancreas houses a fitted canteen. A playground for kids is set up in its spleen. And opportune rentals for first-time homeowners, one-bedroom apartment set up in its boner. So don't dismiss someone as horror absurd on the word of a big lying elephant turd. And when someone tries to warn you off Sarlacc's, now you can tell them to stop talking barlocks.
They came from the cities, they came from the slums. Bounty hunters, we don't need their scum. Gather they did, this band of grim shooters, all aboard Lord Vader's executor. First there was Bosk, a bitter Trandoshan. He came from a planet of mountains and ocean. His skin was green, but he was no rookie, though failed did he to make a slave of the Wookiee. A robot designed to kill sounds great. That was the plan with IG-88. His makers were slaughtered, and all because the robot soon realized it thought therefore it was. And let us please talk of the pair causing a ruckus. A droid and a gand, Forlom and Zuckus. Slowly they climbed the underworld's rungs, all to buy Zuckus a new pair of lungs. His hatred for Solo carried him far, a bandaged old bastard by the name of Dengar. He scowled through his scars, his armor deep black, and he would earn his other name, Payback. And there's one other name we cannot forget, most famous of all, the one they call Fett. So good was he, even Darth kept relations, though he had to stress no disintegrations. Their legends aren't up there with Jedi Knights, but tales of these hunters they always delight. Be they soulless fiends or heroes misguided, these characters are the ones with whom I have sided. Keep your old Jedi and stuff your Sith Lords, these men work harder for mealy rewards. They're dark and they're grim, but they're always compelling. It's the tales of the hunters that make Star Wars worth telling.